A very warm welcome in the class of numerical methods. In this module, we are now going to discuss numerical integration. And in numerical integration, we are now going to introduce our third method, which is known as Wedel's rule. We have already discussed the importance of numerical integration in the very introductory lecture. And after that, we have also discussed two more methods. One is trapezoidal rule and another one is Simpson's one-third rule. In both the methods, we have solved some problems and also we have indicated that what are the problems we are getting the exact result and for what are the problems we are not. As well as we have also mentioned and exhibited that the relationship between the error and the number of subintervals introduced for that particular problem and how it plays a vital role in the calculation. Not only that, we have also given the example and along with its justification that in case of trapezoidal rule, there is no such restriction on the number of subintervals. That means it may be odd as well as it may be even. But in Simpson's one-third rule, we have exhibited that it is mandatory to have a number of subintervals in even order, that is in the number of 2, 4, 6 and so on, because the Simpson's one-third rule as well as the composite Simpson's one-third rule is structured in a manner according to its geometrical interpretation also that it requires a number of subintervals as even. Now, in the third method under this category, we are going to discuss in this lecture, that is Wedel's rule. We are going to see obviously the working rule as well as what are the other important requirements for implementing Wedel's rule in this particular lecture. So without any further delay, we are going to start this discussion. So here also our problem is to find out the result of this one, a to b fx dx. Now we are going to write the working rule of this Wedel's rule, but here I want to start it in some different angle. That is, when we are talking about trapezoidal rule, we are not emphasizing any restriction on n, that is the number of subintervals. After that, when we have done the problems on Simpson's one-third rule, we have imposed the condition on number of subintervals and we have that it has to be even. Now, though these formulas are coming from a general formula and putting the values of n in its variation, we are getting these specific rules. If we have the restriction that n has to be a multiple of 6, in this case we are actually getting the rule, we call it Wedel's rule. So in the word of these senses, we can say that Wedel's rule requires the number of subintervals minimum is 6 or in terms of 6p, where p is any integer, p is any positive integer. So that means we can implement trapezoidal rule for 6 subintervals, 12 subintervals, 18 subintervals and so on. Now the rule what we are going to write is like this. Please check it as the Weddell's rule, and obviously it will be composite Weddell's rule if I have the number of subintervals more than 6, that means in terms of 12, 18, 24 and so on. It is, we have to remember it like this, y0 plus 5y1 plus y2 plus 6y3 plus y4 plus 5y5 plus y6. I want to emphasize on two parts. First one is that, look at this, as we are having here 6 subintervals, so it will give you actually 7 points. So I have started with from x0 along with x1, x2, dot dot dot, we will go up to x6, and you know that the gap is h. Here h is b minus a by n, so here it is x6 minus x0 by 6. And one thing I want to give you as a clue, that for working rule synchronization with your memory, you can keep this sequence in your mind, 1, 5, 1, 6, 1, 5, 1. What is this sequence? This is nothing but the coefficients of y0, y1, y2, y3, y4, y5, y6 in Weddell's rule. Because it is a lengthy formula, you have to know some process through which you can recall the working rule when it will be required. But before going into the problem, I want to say one more thing. Instead of x0 to x6, if it is x0 to x12, then the integration will be done by x0 to x6 plus x6 to x12. So 3h by 10 y0 plus dot 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 plus y6 plus, for the next part it will start from y6 plus dot 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 plus y12. Look at this, don't get any confusion in these dot dots, that is it will be already y1, y2, y3. No, we are talking about Weddell's rule. So obviously here it will be 5y1 plus y2 and so on. Similarly y6 plus 5y7 plus y8 and so on. I want to emphasize on this part, that when it will be your composite Weddell's rule, you can write it two separate manners, or you can composite it with only the intermediate points which are having the index as a multiple of 6. So here you get 2y6 but y12 and y0. If it goes to y18, then it will be 2y6, 2y12, but y18 will remain as y18. So I think you have the understanding from the conversion of Weddell's rule to composite Weddell's rule. Now we are going to solve some problem, very basic problem on Weddell's rule. So first of all, I want to solve 0 to suppose 6 x dx, the simplest problem. And why I am solving it in this way? Because I know that it will be x square by 2 in the exactness 0 to 6. So it will be 6 into 6 by 2, that is 18. It is its exact result, we know. So let us check what will be the result of this integration using the Weddell's rule. So here mine, when I am going to do this, so here my a is 0, b is 6, h is b minus a by n and for the simplicity we are taking n is equal to 6, so it will be 6 minus 0 by 6, that is 1. So I need now the table. X, y, here y is equal to fx and for our problem it is simply as x. So it will be 0, then 0 plus h, that is 1, then 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Similarly, we are getting that y as will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and we can make it very clear that it is my y0, y1, y2, y3, y4, y5, y6. So according to the formula, I can write 3h by 10 y0 plus 5y1, 15, 16, 151. Okay. So h is known to us, it is 3 into 1 by 10, y0 is 0 plus 5 into y1, that is 5, plus y2, that is 2, plus y3 is here 3, so 6 into 3, 18, plus y4, that is 4, plus y5, that is 5, 5 into 5, 25, plus y6 is 6. So if we add this, what we are going to get? 5, 7, 25, 25 plus 25, 50 plus 10, that is 60. So simplifying this, we get it as 18, which is nothing but the exact result of this one. So for this particular problem, we are having one confidence that Wedel's rule actually plays the correct process for finding out the result. It gives us the confidence. But here also we are seeing that there is no error. But is it true that it will never bring error? What is your answer? The answer is no, you can't say like this, because you have to check, like the previous lectures, it for x square, then for x cube, then for x to the power 4 and so on. And obviously you can't generalize it until and unless you are going to establish some theorem. And in case of any intermediate step, you are getting that the error is coming, then obviously you can't say that this process is going to be exact for all the cases. So this is a very important verification from your side. Please do this. And before concluding this lecture, I just want to exhibit one more problem on Wedel's rule. We have to evaluate log x dx from 4 to 5.2 using Wedel's rule, taking n is equal to 6. So here my function is log x, then the value of b is 5.2, the value of a is 4 and the value of n is 6. All are provided. Our next step is to calculate the value of h. And we know that H is equal to B minus A by N. So now it will be 5.2 in place of B, in place of A it is 4, and in place of N it is 6. So by calculating, what we get? 1.2 by 6, that is 0.2. So from this we get the value of x and fx as 4. So let us construct the table. Here I want to say one thing to all of you, that though the problems are very easy, but still when you are going to calculate those values, you have to follow some instruction that what is required up to which precision level. So if the thing is required for 4 decimal places, and if the thing is required for 2 decimal places, the calculations will be of different angle and different type. So here we will get 7 points as n is equal to 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then it is 6 and 7. And if I proceed for the values of x, obviously it will start from 4. Then 4 plus 0.2, that is 4.2. Similarly, it will be 4.4, 4.6, 4.8, 5.0, we can write it as 4.0, and 5.2. After that, putting those values into fx equal to log x, we are getting these values from our calculators. For 4.6, it will be 1.5261. Just use your calculator in the proper manner, and obviously you please be cautious about using ln and log. According to the requirement, you have to place those functional keys. After completing this table, we can proceed for the formula. So from Weidel's rule of numerical integration, we can write as I, that is 4 to 5.2 log x dx, it will be 3h by 10. Obviously we must mention always the formula, don't write the informations directly, because in that case it is not possible for us to verify whether the rule is properly known to us or not. Similarly, we are not able to check in case of composite rules that whether we are implementing the composite rules in the proper manner or not. So putting the value of h 0.2, we'll get this one. And for y0 plus 5y1 in this manner, if I want to write, it will be 1.3863 plus 5 into 1.4351 plus y2, that is 1.4816 plus 6y3, so 6 into y3 is 1.5261 plus y4, that is 1.5686 plus 5y5, so 5 into 1.6094 plus y6. So it will be only 1.6487. So obviously I am not going to show this calculation over here. You can do it by your own and you will get the result as 1.8279. So this is the answer, and for your own inquisitiveness, I am just requesting you to solve this problem by the classical method and check the amount of error in this particular calculation. So here we are going to stop our discussion on Weddell's rule. We have already discussed the working rule with some examples. So I want that you please go through these references for your further knowledge and further discussions on these particular topics. And also, these are the limited assignments. Along with this, you please solve some more problems to make some confidence on this particular method. And finally, I want to thank you all. Happy listening, happy learning.